This is Kenneth Turan of the Los Angeles Times, and this is my DVD pick of the week. This week I want to look at two sides of Humphrey Bogart through two new Blu-ray releases. The first one is one of Bogart's classic films, The Big Sleep. This is from the Raymond Chandler novel. It's a Los Angeles-based detective story. It stars Bogart as Philip Marlowe, Chandler's great detective, investigating all kinds of nefarious doings. It's also one of the classic pairings of Bogart and Lauren Bacall, who later became his wife. One of the virtues of this disc is that you can see an earlier version of this film put together by Robert Gitt from the UCLA Film and Television Archive that really makes more sense than this film did. The film was recut to make more space for Lauren Bacall, and by doing that, some of the plot got lost.
You wanted to see me?
So you're a private detective. I didn't know they existed except in books, or else they were greasy little men snooping around hotel corridors. Ah, you're a mess, aren't you?
I'm not very tall, either. Next time I'll come on stilts, wear a white tie, and carry a tennis racket.
I doubt if even that would help. Now, this business of Dad's, think you can handle it for him?
It shouldn't be too tough.
Really? I would have thought a case like that took a little effort.
Not too much.
What will your first step be?
The usual one.
I didn't know there was a usual one.
Oh, sure there is. It comes complete with diagrams on page 47 of how to be a detective and 10 easy lessons, correspondence school textbook, and your father offered me a drink.
You must have read another one on how to be a comedian.
Hear what I said about the drink?
I'm quite serious, Mr. Marlowe. My father's
not... Father...
Help yourself.
The other Bogart film is a personal favorite. It's Beat the Devil. It's directed by the great John Huston, and it's on a new film detective release. This is really kind of a spoof. This is a funny film. This is a spoof of adventure films, a spoof of foreign intrigue. Bogart has co-stars like Robert Morley and Peter Lorre that really have some wonderfully funny lines that will make you really happy you're watching.
Time. What is time? Swiss manufactured, French ordered, Italian squandered. Americans say it is money. Hindus say it does not exist. You know what I say? I say time is a crook.
If we took a plane, we'd be there inside 15 hours instead of who knows where.
I don't want any more talk about flying. The sky is for the birds. My feet are on the ground. Both of them. Come in, Billy boy.
What's all the fuss about?
No fuss, Billy. We're merely wondering what course to pursue in view of this unfortunate delay.
Join the peasants in their revels. Go to church. Write your memoirs.
Very funny. I like an associate of mine to have a sense of humor. Good laugh does more for the stomach muscles than 5 minutes setting up exercises. And now that we've had our moment of fun, and all the better for it, let's get back to the question. Doesn't this delay call for a cable to your friend in British East?
Mustn't send cables. Can't you get it through your heads that the population down there has trained noses? They can smell a uranium deal like a cat smells fish.
But aren't you afraid, Billy, that when our little party doesn't show up on the date you said, aren't you a teeny bit afraid that your friend might use this as an excuse to begin negotiations elsewhere?
If my friend were looking for an excuse, he'd find a better one in the morning papers.
What do you mean?
I'm talking about the untimely demise of Paul Van Meer.
I'm appalled, Billy. What an unwholesome opinion you must have of your colleagues. To imagine that we...
Look here, Peterson, you don't have to convince me of anything. You don't care what I think as long as I don't do anything about it. And I won't, unless you ever decide to sic that knife-happy little junkie on me.
Watch yourself, Letty.
Now, Jack, behave yourself. Sit down. For shame, Billy. I think you owe an apology to everybody in this room. And if you're half the gentleman I know you are, I'm sure you'll make it.
As I was saying, Peterson, you have nothing to worry about. My friend won't pull out unless I tell him to. For purely venal reasons, that's the last thing I have in mind.
Jack, give Billy a light.